This recipe was adapted from Ina Garten's beef short ribs recipe that's available on foodnetwork.com. There are several differences in my recipe than Ina's, one of which being additional dry seasonings that were included, as well as the omission of the fennel and leeks. And I also included chopped bacon in the recipe and a cup of flour, 1/4 cup of flour. So first things first, you want to start with thoroughly washed and clean short ribs trimmed of excess fat. I seasoned the short ribs liberally with sea salt and black pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and a little bit of herbs de Provence. After I seasoned the short ribs, I add a dusting of flour. You can use self-rising flour, or you can use all-purpose flour. After I coat the ribs with the flour mixture, I then go ahead and saute my bacon. I put a little bit of oil in your pan. Then you want to actually sear off the short ribs. So put only enough ribs in the pot and don't overcrowd. If you overcrowd, you won't get a good sear and then instead steam. So I flip them over after maybe 3 minutes and sear them off, 3 minutes on each side, pull them out, and then I add the carrots, the onions, and the celery. At this point, you wanna add your seasonings, your additional seasonings, and your herbs. So I pretty much add everything else: adobo seasoning, the crushed red pepper flakes, some more black pepper, some more sea salt, herbs de Provence, onion powder, garlic powder, fresh thyme. I'm adding my bay leaves, and I'm also adding the fresh garlic, and saute this down. Once it gets to, you know, a softer texture, I'm adding my beef stock or your beef bouillon cube. Just add water and then add one beef bouillon. You also add the red wine at this point. Bring it up to a boil, and once you have it, it'll boil. You cover it and then you put it in the oven at 350 for roughly 3 hours. At the 2.5 hour mark, you want to pull it out and you want to check to see if the consistency of the stock is how you want. Top it with some mashed potatoes, and voila, it's done.